Hi everyone, this is Kristie Taylor from the Art Anthology Dream Team. Today I'd like to show you how I created this three canvas home decor piece using a combination of Art Anthology's new Minx Shimmering inks and some awesome new collections from Melissa Francis. I started out by picking out the pieces I wanted to use. I laid them all out, taking them out of the package and played with placement. This took me a little while to decide exactly how I wanted everything to look. But I did notice that this cute little bag with the saying on it fit perfectly inside my frame. So yep, that's where that's going. I love Melissa Francis's new chipboard pieces. They're thick and durable, but easy enough to cut so that you can reshape them for any project. Here I'm using Art Anthology's mud and an Art Anthology stencil to add texture and shapes to the wood frame. Also, you'll notice my awesome Princeton Artist Tool. I love this tool and I think I pretty much use it on every project. Just spreading the mud over the stencil and then lifting the stencil up. This will leave a cool 3D design behind. I did it around the frame. And then I also did it on the two smaller canvases, but in random places. I didn't cover the whole canvas. Clean off the edges, because it does stick off the edges. Put it back in the jar, because you're going to want that for later. And dry it with a heat tool. Took a while to get all that dry, but just keep going until it's all dry and you can touch it without it moving. Next, I used my hot glue gun to adhere the chipboard pieces to the frame. One thing I've found that really helps me is when you play with your placement beforehand, take a picture of it with your cell phone and then you can look at it before you glue everything down. This helps you remember exactly where you had everything. After that, I glued some lace around the edges of each canvas to give it more texture. This also adds that awesome vintage look that Melissa Francis is so famous for. Went around the edge of each canvas, and then we have to paint everything with gesso. A thin coat will do just fine. All you're doing is giving the place for the paint to stick. Cover everything with gesso and then heat it with a heat tool to dry the paint. Don't forget to get inside the edges. Dry it with a heat tool. Now for the fun part. Let's add some color. I chose three colors of the Minx Shimmering inks. Whoops, I dropped it. Just add a little circle of it here and there. These inks are very viscous, so they stick to the surface, but they're also very fluid and highly pigmented. This allows for great color adhesion, but also some movement. So you'll see me drip some around each canvas, spread it with my fingers, and I also pick the canvas up and tap it on my table. And this gives the ink a chance to move around. I add the green and then dry it with a heat tool. This keeps the colors from all molding together. I kind of wanted them a little bit separate. takes a while to dry all that wet ink, but it's worth it. Now let's add the beautiful blue. This is a gorgeous color. Add it to different areas of each canvas. And don't forget to go behind your chipboard pieces. I'm going to spread it out with a paintbrush, still leaving some white places for the third color. Once I've got it all spread out the way I like it, we're going to heat it with a heat tool to dry it. Once that's dry, we're going to add the third color, the beautiful brown. This allows us to have a nice antiqued look. And don't forget that these inks have all that gorgeous shimmer, so you get the antique vintagey look along with the beautiful shimmer that gives it a gorgeous sheen. I just added the brown in random places. Then use my fingers to spread it out a little bit. Don't forget to get those inside edges. I glued the sentiment back into the middle. This is that bag with the saying on it that came in the kit. And then hot glued the flea market find metal pieces onto the canvases. Now you could alter these metal pieces and change the color, but I really thought that the silver that they came as was perfect to go with the patina that we created.